just welcome your presence here, God. We thank you that we can come into a place of worship, Lord. And we just want to adore you this morning, mighty God. Lift your voice up this morning, church of God. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Oh, we thank you for praise, Lord. We set the atmosphere this morning. Are you excited to be in God's house this morning? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the highway. Yeah. We have a lot of space in the front of the house this morning. Be free on your worship.
The rocks will cry out. The oceans will roar. The mountains will bow to the name of the Lord. God is our God. God will be praised. The idols will fall. The strongholds will break. Every weapon that forms will shatter and fail. God is our God. God is our faith.
Praise is the highway.
Praise is the highway to the throne of God. Praise is the highway to the heart of God. Praise is the highway to the move of God.
Oh, praise is the highway.
Yes, Lord. Praise is the highway to the throne of God. Praise is the highway to the heart of God. Praise is the highway to the move of God.
Oh, revival will come.
Revival will come. The church will awake. God's anthem will drown all other refrains. God is our song. God forever reigns.
Praise is the highway.
Praise is the highway to the throne of God. Praise is the highway to the heart of God. Praise is the highway to the move of God.
Oh, we lift up your head.
Lift up your head. Fling wide the gates. Break down the walls with a shout of praise. Lift up your voice. Pull heaven down. Oh, sing like thunder. God's praise is loud.
Lift up.
Lift up your head, fling wide the gates, break down the walls with a shout of praise. Lift up your voice, pull heaven down, or sing like thunder, God's praise is loud. Praise is the highway to the throne of God. Praise is the highway to the heart of God. Praise is the highway to the move of God.
Praise is the highway.
Praise is the highway to the throne of God. Praise is the highway to the heart of God. Praise is the highway to the move of God.
So lift up your head.
Lift up your head. Fling wide the gates. Break down the walls with a shout of praise. Lift up your voice. Pull heaven down. Sing like thunder, God's praise is loud. Lift up your head, fling wide the gates. Break down the walls with a shout of praise. Lift up your voice, pull heaven down. We'll sing like thunder, God's praise is loud. Breezes the highway to the throne of God. Breezes the highway to the heart of God. Breezes the highway to the move of God.
How many of you are hungry for the move of God? Let praise be upon your lips. Praise is the highway.
Breeze is the highway to the throne of God. Breeze is the highway to the heart of God. Breeze is the highway to the move of God.
Oh, lift up your voice.
Lift up your head. Fling wide the gates. Break down the walls with a shout of praise. Lift up your voice, pull heaven down. Sing like thunder, God's praise is loud. Lift up your head, fling wide the gates. Break down the walls with a shout of praise. Lift up your voice, pull heaven down. Sing like thunder, God's praise is loud. Lift up your head, fling wide the gates.
Come on now.
Break down these walls with your shout of praise. Lift up your voice, call heaven down. Sing like thunder, God's praise is loud. Lift up your head, fling wide the gates. Break down the walls with a shout of praise. Lift up your voice, pull heaven down. Sing like thunder, God's praise is loud. Breeze is my highway to the throne of God. Breeze is my highway to the heart of God. Breeze is my highway to the move of God.
Come on, let's declare that praise is the highway.
Breeze is my highway to the throne of God. Breeze is my highway to the heart of God. Breeze is my highway to the move of God.
Come on, give Jesus a hand this morning. Worthy of praise, worthy of glory. Hallelujah. Oh, Rama. No fire can burn us, Lord. No fire.
Fire can burn me, no battle can turn me, no mountain can stop me, cause you hold my hand. And I'm walking in your victory, cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, cause you hold my hand. Victory, cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, cause you hold my hand. You know my name. You know my name. Yes, you know my name. So now. I pour out my heart to you. Ooh, yes, here in your presence I am made new. Ooh, yes. So now I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence I am made new. So now I pour out. Come on, let's sing it together. So now I pour out my heart to you. Oh, lift your hands this morning. Here in your presence I am made new. I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence I am made new. You know my name. You know my name. Oh, my name, how you comfort me. Oh, how you comfort me. Oh, how you counsel me. Yet it still amazes me that I am your friend. You know my name. You know my name. What's written in the tablets? You know my name on your heart, Lord. You know my name. You know my name. Oh, how you comfort me. And oh, how you counsel me. It still amazes me that I am your friend.
Come on, declare, no fire can burn you.
No fire can burn me. No battle can turn me. No mountain can stop me. 'Cause you hold my hand. I'm walking in your victory. 'Cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, 'cause you hold my hand. No fire can burn me, no battle can turn me, no mountain can turn me, 'cause you hold my hand. I'm walking in your victory, 'cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, 'cause you hold my hand. No fire can burn me, no battle can turn me, no mountain can stop me, 'cause you hold my hand. Now I'm walking in your victory, 'cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, 'cause you hold my hand. 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 And oh, how you walk with me. Oh, how you talk with me. And oh, how you tell me that I am yours. So now, so now, I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence, I am made new. So now I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence, I am made new. So now, one more time. So now, I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence, I am made new. So now I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence I am made new.
We're made new in your presence, Lord. So now,
so now, I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence, I am made new. You know my name. Oh, the Lord speaking to you. You know my name. You're not forgotten. You know my name. You know my name. Come and declare that to the Lord this morning. You know my name. You know my name. Some of you need to know that this morning. You know my name. You know my name. You know my name. No fire, no fire can burn me. No battle can turn me. No mountain can stop me. 'Cause you hold my hand. And I'm walking in your victory. 'Cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me, 'cause you hold my hand. No fire
can burn me, no battle can burn me,
no mountain
can stop me, 'cause
you hold my hand. Now I'm walking
in your victory, 'cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me,
'cause you hold my hand. Hold my hand. You 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 hold my hand. And every step of the way, you hold my hand. You hold my hand.
Oh, oh, how you comfort me. Oh, just sing it to the Lord.
Oh, how you counsel me. And and it still amazes me that I am your friend. So now I pour out my heart to you.
Oh, just pour it out.
Here in your presence I am made new. So now I pour out my heart to
It's just so amazing, just as we worship the Lord this morning, all hands lifted up, all hands lifted up, all eyes put on the Lord. The Lord just spoke to me to remind every single person in this house, every single person, and even those watching online about your calling, that there is a calling unique to your life. Something, not just the calling to commissioning is there, but there is something right now that the Lord has for you to do. It's the calling part that God is interested in right now. The commissioning part will come later. But there are things that God is calling you to do right now. To be a part of this house and to work in synchronization with the Holy Spirit. Not just on a Sunday. But in the ministries of the house of God, God is calling you to go deeper. For everything that we are called to requires higher levels of commitment. How many know that? Don't be afraid of that, I believe. The Lord wants to encourage you this morning, to encourage you to go deeper. Don't be afraid to go deeper. Because when we walk and move with God, we flourish. Yeah. We flourish. You don't have to fear rejection. You don't have to fear criticism. You don't have to fear the things that have often pushed you away. You need to only fear the Lord your God, the God of glory and grace, the great I am. But there are callings on each of your lives, and there's something specific that God is calling you to do right now. It's passed through in your mind, but you haven't articulated it in the flesh. It's passed through in your spirit, but you haven't articulated it necessarily in the flesh. So like I said, the calling is part of that which leads up to your commissioning. But what can you do right now? For the kingdom. For God wants to lift up the house so that others can be healed. Others can experience the joy of the Lord. Remember what we said at Sozo. Remember what we said. It's in the refiner's fire that the joy comes. Hallelujah. It's in the fire of purification. It's in the fire of alignment that the joy comes. Because as we release our healing and our stuff and our issues and our problems and our struggles and our everyday life occurrences that bring distraction and get in our way and that cause us to worry, as we bring those and lay them at the feet of Jesus, something shifts in our lives. You've got to know that everybody in this place is going through something today. Everybody in this place is experiencing something in their lives that may cause worry or confusion or stress or struggle. Everybody has their own stuff. Somebody say amen. Amen. Everybody is carrying something. Come on.
Yes, amen.
But you've got to be carrying the fire of God so that you can release your burdens and lay them at the feet of Jesus. Jesus says in Matthew 11, 29 or 30, Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who are heavy burdened and laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light, and you will find rest for your souls. For I am gentle and humble in heart." You'll find peace and rest. Paraphrased. Don't first go to the mind's eye. Don't first go to the place of worry. Don't first go where the enemy rents space in your mind and steals your joy and steals the amazing words that God has put on your heart just the week before, just the day before, just the hour before.
Yeah.
But allow the Spirit of God to take residence in every part of your life. So that no matter what comes your way, no matter what the struggle, no matter how great, no matter how small, you can say, "I lay my burdens at the feet of Jesus. I come before you, Lord." If you do worry about the sparrow that should fall and what it should eat, even as Matthew 6 teaches us, how much more shall God, your heavenly parent in heaven, be worried about you that even the hairs, very hairs on your head are numbered? So lay those burdens at the feet of Jesus today. Let the joy of the Lord rise up as you take to heart and remind yourself of the amazing things that the Lord has said and spoken into your life so many times. Can somebody say amen in the house? I'm starting to feel nervous. Can somebody say amen in the house? Can somebody say, "I stand in agreement with that word this morning"? Can somebody say, "The Lord is truth"? And everything that God says is truth.
Hallelujah.
And I want to worship the Lord in spirit and in.
Yes, truth.
And in.
Truth.
And in.
Truth.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The truth is, I may have some problems. The truth is, I may have some struggles. But the one who is truth takes and carries all my burdens. The greater I am, the one who knows all things about me, who created me when I was still in my mom's womb. For purpose. Not just the destination, but for purpose here and now in the calling. Shondalabaka Sorobo Sheki Bimasata. Oh, Marika. Have I not said it shall be just as I have heard you decree? Every word as you bow your knee. I say, my child, so it shall be. So it shall be as you bow your knee. As you bow your knee. Don't be hindered and sweat the small stuff. For your God of glory is more than enough. Oh. Yield. And bow the knee, and you will see. Shukarabaka. Heaven is coming down. And in your moment of grief, of stress, of strife, know that I am with you. And know that nothing can separate you from me, the Lord would say. Nothing. Nothing on heaven, nothing on earth. Can separate you from my love, can separate you from my presence. For I am the Lord your God, the God of Israel, the God of Rebekah, the God of Jacob, the God of Isaac, the God of Deborah. I am the Lord your God who sets things in place and in order to which I have called you. The Lord would say, don't yield back. Yield to me, but don't yield back from what I have for you. So the Lord said, yield to me, but step into what I have for you. So don't yield back. Yield to the Lord. And as you yield to the Lord, as you bow your knee, step into what the Lord has for you. The question of our mindsets is the continual paradox between being a Christian living in the Spirit and living in a real world with real problems and real issues. But we take authority in the name of Jesus over everything that should come in to corrupt our minds. And we say we renew our minds according to Scripture each and every day. If your mind is the greatest place you are attacked, as it is for most Christians, you have to lay that down. You have to say, Lord, no space is going to be rented to the enemy. Yes. You've got to know it when you see it. And you've got to start speaking out the word over your life. You've got to take that psalm and begin to speak it aloud out of your mouth, because it creates everything in the atmosphere to show. Shift and change. You may not know it, but the devil does. But if you know it, you have even greater authority over it. Does any of that make sense this morning? The Lord wants you to know that you're above and not below. Oh, come on. You're above and not below. You're the head and not the tail. The Lord your God goes with you. Just as the army of Gideon took thousands, and the Lord said, you don't need them. You need 600. Yes. Watch and see those that come by the stream, and see how they take the water from the stream. And if they drink it in a certain way, you will know those are the ones to stay and which ones are to go. Because the Lord is strategic in everything the Lord does. So it's not about the size of the army. Do you hear me, church, this morning? Yes, it's not about the size of the army. It's about the size of my spirit. Lord, it's about the size of my faith. Yes. It's about the size of my passion.
Yes.
Shunda lama. It's about what I know that I know that I know that no one can steal from me or take away from me, yes, no matter what is going on in my life. Hallelujah. That's why when I come into church and into the house every Sunday, I come not just for refreshing and but for renewal, and to remind me that as the word, like right now, is being spoken over me, my faith increases.
Yes,
when I'm together with other believers, my faith increases.
Amen.
Something begins to shift, yes, and move me. That doesn't move me when I'm on my own.
Yes.
Are you hearing me, church? Mm-hmm. That's why when Teacher David said earlier, we mustn't give up meeting together, as Hebrews 10 says. Some are in the habit of doing that. Don't give up meeting together, but have constant fellowship so that your faith can be increased. And speak in psalms and hymns. Ephesians 5 says, speak in psalms and hymns to one another. Because all the as you see the day approaching, you'll be able to encourage one another, yes, with those things. Mm. Come on. We don't need the army of 10,000. Let, yes, the Lord take care of that. Just make sure that the army we have are equipped and ready,
yes,
to go. Don't let anything stop you from getting on your marks, like I spoke about last week. Getting on your marks, being ready, having your eyes peeled, having your discernment strong, growing and being equipped in every area that God has for you, so that you can make ready everything that is ahead of you and be ready for everything that is ahead of you. You cannot walk into the Monday of the Sunday and walk into that Monday and suddenly you don't even remember what you did at church on Sunday. You have to know what God has poured in you stays with you. It doesn't matter if something comes in your way to overtake you. The God of glory and grace is still the same God that you are hearing about, that you are experiencing right now in this house today. Of all the prophetic words spoken over you, of all the words of encouragement that Scripture and the Word of God have spoken and declared over your life, they are still true no matter what happens in your life. Because God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. God's plans may shift and focus may shift because God's merciful on the earth and sees how fickle everybody else is. and takes hold of who we are. And God's mercy and grace moves and shifts strategy so that we can always be included and that we always have an opportunity. Does that make sense? I didn't read from the word this morning, but I quoted it. And I want you to always make sure that you are reading your word because it will equip you. It will help you to progress in everything you do. God wants to speak deeply through the word. Now I say to you again, we are a Gideon's army. We're a Gideon's army in this church. We are building a sure foundation. We're a Gideon's army. The objective of the enemy is to take out those as he sees them growing, because when you grow in the house of the Lord, you become a threat to the enemy's camp. That's why what I've preached before is just before you're due for promotion, every distraction you could think of without you realizing it comes in your way. Because if he can even set the timing of God back, he can't stop what God's doing. But if he can just set the timing back a little bit, if he can just create more stress, if he can just create a little bit more delay so that maybe just someone else's house, someone else's faith in the house will dwindle and they will fall off the bus. Just if he can create more delays and just show that God's not working. If he can just, but he cannot stop what God is doing.
Yes,
remember what Gamaliel said in the scripture. We know clearly that there is nothing that can change what happened in the scripture in Acts chapter 5, where Gamaliel stood up to the whole council and said, listen, if these men, the apostles, if they are not of God, listen, it will fail. No matter what they do, it will fail. But if it if it is of God, you can't stop them.
Hallelujah.
Nothing can stop them.
Amen.
With the army of Gideon, nothing can stop what God is doing. You don't look at the number of 10,000 because you don't need the army of 10,000. You just need the army of 600 that will come and that will be committed enough to say, you know what, I'm going through some things, but God is on my side.
Hallelujah.
I'm going through some stuff, but God has got my back. I have some issues happening. I have some financial difficulties, and I'm going to share. I'm going to share things I've never shared with my pastors. I'm going to share things in my fellowship group that I've never shared. I'm going to go to life group because I've never gone before. I'm going to go because I know this is where my strength comes from. This is where my help comes from, is when I'm under the teaching and the anointing of the Word of God. Oh, you've got to understand. Don't be consumed with all those other things. There's enough of them to keep us busy till eternity, seriously. So what will keep you busy? What's going to keep you busy? What's going to keep you busy? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh gosh, hallelujah.
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 God knows, you know my name. You formed me in my mother's womb. Every day of my life has been ordained before one of them came to pass, Lord. You said it in Jeremiah 1. You said it in Psalm 139. You said it, God. You said that all my days were ordained for me before one of them came to pass. You know my name. You know everything about me. You know what I'm called to do. And right now, so now,
my heart to you.
Come on, lift your voice. Just sing that out as Pastor Brent sings there.
Here in your presence, I am made new.
So now,
I pour out my heart to you.
Everything about me.
You comfort me. And oh, how you counsel me. Yet it still amazes me that I am your friend. So now, so now, I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence, I am made new.
Oh, sing that out to the Lord. Come on.
So now I pour out my heart to you. Here in your presence, I am made new.
When Ezra stood up as the priest and read the law, he read the word of God, he read the scroll. It said that as Israel had settled in their towns and all the people came together as one in the square, they told Ezra, the teacher of the law, to bring out the book of the law of Moses, the word of God, which the Lord had commanded Israel. So on the first day of the seventh month, Ezra the priest brought the law before the assembly, that was the church, before the people of God. And it was made up of women and men and all children, so all who were there were able to understand. He read it aloud. Listen to this. This is Old Testament. He took the scroll. He took the word of God. The first five books in scripture, the books of Moses, he took the word of God. And it says that all who were able to understand were there. All the families were there. And he read it aloud. Listen to what he did. He read it aloud from daybreak until noon as he faced the square before the water gate in the presence of the men, women, and others who could understand. And all the people listened attentively to the reading of the book of the law. He stood on this high wooden platform built for the occasion. Now you know where we get our high-in-the-sky pulpits from, right? And then it speaks about how he opened the book and all the people could see him because he was standing above them, and he opened it. And as he opened it, the people stood up and Ezra praised the Lord, the great God. And all the people lifted their hands and they responded, amen, amen, amen. Amen. This is Old Testament. This is before they had the baptism of the Holy Spirit. This is before we even saw the Spirit of God move the way we see the Spirit of God move in the book of Acts. Yes. This is in the book of Nehemiah. From morning, from daybreak, not even 10 a.m. When does the sun come up? 5 a.m. Maybe 4:30 in summer. 4:30 to noon. They listened attentively. And what did the word say? It says that Ezra, the one reading the word, praised the Lord. And all the people lifted their hands. Old Testament, lifted their hands and responded, amen, amen. And then they bowed down and they worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. And that's where we get the scripture in Nehemiah 8:10 where he says, don't grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. We've got to learn to shout some more amens. We're going to learn to take our watches off at church. We've got to learn to respond, not based on when we hear a crowd response, but based on our heart response, because our hearts are connected with the Most High God. Come on, someone, tell me you want to say amen. Don't wait for your neighbor to say it. Lead the way with it. Start the atmosphere. Shift the atmosphere. Don't wait for somebody else. You are the one. And they lifted their hands. And they shouted, amen, amen to the word of God. Because the Bible says that all were there who understood. When you understand the magnitude of the scripture, when you understand the magnitude of the word of God, it carries a power that is supernatural, even as it is read. Even as it is spoken, even as it is taught, because it's the word of God. The Bible says that the word was with God, and somebody get out John 1 and read verse 1 for me. Somebody else, read it. Come and bring it out, Grant, bring it out. We got to know. The God we serve and the power that the Word of God carries, it's not just a scripture for a Sunday morning to make us feel a little holier than now or to make us feel we've done something right. We've got to understand the impact of this Word in our lives. It reminds us of what not to do and what to do. It not only teaches us, but the revelation of it in these very pages opens us up to what God is saying in our lives. Amen. John 1, Gospel of John 1, verse 1. Can you come up here, Gron? Just read it for me.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning.
You want to theologize that? Sholaba karaba shenda. God was made flesh in the form of Jesus Christ. So that the Bible says that Jesus was the very image of God. Not talking about gender and all that stuff. We're talking about the characteristics. We're talking about the personhood of the Godhead of Jesus Christ and of God, the Most High God. And I tell you what, if we can't shout amens when we are a Gideon's army, what will we do? Because it was the sound that they released that won them so many wars. It was a strategy of how to break down hell by shutting out heaven. Oh, I'm telling you some truths this morning. You can't be afraid to shout the first amen. You can't be afraid to do the first altar call dance. You can't be afraid to come up here and shout out what is in your heart. Because when you shut it up, it shuts up.
Yes, amen.
Don't wait for anybody else. You are the one. Are you hearing me, church? We are the army of Gideon, and we're moving forward, and we're marching in the word of God, and we're marching in the one who is then and now and will be forever. His name is Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. Jesus. And you want to shout it out, and David was undignified before God because he was taken in by the very Spirit of God. Yes. And he could not control what was inside him. He just had to shout it out. He just had to dance it out. He just had to shout out his hallelujahs and his amens. He couldn't keep it in anymore. He said, this is my God, hallelujah, the one who I praise, for I have seen the work of God in my life. I have seen the God that is not just the God of glory, but the God of the supernatural. From daybreak till noon. How can people in the Old Testament still keep occupied in reading the word? You know how they say, oh, you've only got a 10-minute attention span. Don't preach longer than 30 minutes. Don't preach. When you're in the Spirit and you're having an encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ, have you ever turned around and looked and said, my gosh, is it that late? Sometimes you can be in there for 2 hours, 3 hours, and you're like, where did the time go? Because that's the spiritual timeline, and our heavenly timeline, our supernatural timeline, the one that's God's timeline, is not the same as our timeline. God doesn't operate on our timeline. And when we allow ourselves, it's Kairos time, when we allow ourselves to be totally immersed in the Spirit, and I'm not saying you walk in every single Sunday and you fire it up every Sunday, but by the time you leave here, you want to be. Hallelujah. By the time you leave here, you want to know that faith, a new faith has arisen. Not that you stay on milk, but that there's a new faith that has arisen. There's a new empowerment. There's something that has shifted in you. You've been empowered and equipped that Sunday. You've learned something else. And I want to challenge you today. When you walk out of this place and you have your quiet time tomorrow, I want you to ask yourself this question. Lord, what were you teaching me yesterday? What was the teacher? What did you want me to get from that if you haven't already got it, right? And if you got it, you got to say, yes, Lord. Put it in my spirit. Yes. Just put it in so that it's so deep, Lord. Yes. Put it in so that nothing can stop it when I need it. Yes. Do you get what I'm saying? They worshiped. And even after they shouted their amens and had lifted their hands in the Old Testament, oh yes. My gosh, the religious folk will be horrified. They lifted their hands. I remember doing one of my assignments at Varsity in theology on that. They lifted their hands to worship the Lord. And they didn't even just stop at the amens. They didn't even just stop at the lifting of their hands. After that, the Bible says that they bowed down on their faces. On their faces. When does that happen? When does it happen? It happens when the presence of God overwhelms and overcomes you. Because you're so in it. You're in the moment. No matter how long the moment is, it doesn't matter. And sometimes the reality is that hunger is not always there to rush into church on a Sunday. Sometimes the reality is that the things of the world just kind of block us up a little bit. And we just sometimes think, maybe I should just miss church today. Or maybe there's something else that creates a little bit more importance because I haven't really dealt with something else in my life. And so I just kind of, that's when you got to say, listen, what does God want from me? I know that I'm meant to be there because my flesh is willing, but my spirit is willing, but my flesh is weak, is what Paul said. And that's going to happen all the time. There's always going to be a conflict between the spirit and the flesh, amen? But you know what? We don't live by the flesh, we live by the spirit. And so when you know that's happening to you, you've got to know that there's something great about to happen to your church when the enemy doesn't want you to go. Or a word that he doesn't want you to hear because it's for you. Yeah. You know how many times I've seen that happen? Where the enemy keeps people away because their minds get consumed and distracted. And the word for that Sunday was just for them. I mean, I don't want us to be people that say, that word was for him. Oh, that word was for... Always for me first, right? We've got to say that word. What do you want to say to me, Lord? I know all that stuff already. God's bringing us fresh revelation every Sunday in this house. Fresh revelation. This morning is fresh revelation. There's some things we forgot about that we needed to remember. And more than that, we needed to take hold of. Because not only do we have the Spirit of God coming upon us, but we have the Spirit of God residing in us. Where the Bible says in John 7:38 that those rivers of living water are in us. But some of our stagnant pools had stayed stagnant for so long, we've forgotten what's inside us. And sometimes we get birthed into a place of absolute silence when we should be shouting out, amen, amen, victory is mine. Look at the opposition that Nehemiah faced in the building of those walls, and that's another story for another time. There were many distractions. There were many that came against the building of the temple. There were many that came against, because the enemy didn't want to see that rebuilt, the temple or the city or the, he wanted everything to stay in ruins. He wants your life to stay in ruins. But Jesus Christ died on the cross so that you could have the victory, so that every ruin, every brick could be rebuilt in the image of Jesus Christ. Yes. And that no matter what happened to you as a child, and no matter who tried to tell you you were nothing and wouldn't amount to anything, and no matter how much rejection had come upon you in your life as a child or in your life as an adult, nothing could stop the destiny and purpose that God has for every single believer. Nothing can stop it. No matter what. with all our idiosyncrasies, with all our issues, with all our problems, with all our struggles, with all the wrong things that we say to one another. Jesus Christ has come to bring us into that place and lift up the ruins of who we are and build us into strong towers that represent Jesus Christ in this house and out of in the world. And that we then draw off, because the Spirit of God lives in each one of us, we draw off the power of the magnificent Most High God that has been privileged enough, we're privileged enough to have it living in us. That we can touch someone and say, listen, do you know Jesus? And pray over them and the Spirit of God comes. Or that they need healing and we can pray over them. You can't worry, well, if what happens if they don't get healed? You're just called to pray, just do your job. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing that in my situation right now, in my life, with what's happening in our family. It's all I can do. It's all I can do. I'm not saying, oh, well, God, you know, God, how can you let this happen? God didn't make that happen. Sickness is from the pit of hell. And there are many things that we do in our lives that we mess up things in our lives. Others are just because we've got certain dispositions to certain illness. But no matter what, the small seed comes from the pit of hell. I can do nothing, but I must continue to pray. I must continue to have faith and leave the rest to God. If it's her time, she's going to go. If it's not, she'll be healed. But I'm going to pray a prayer of faith for her healing. I'm not living in a false reality, but I'm not going to stop having faith. And every time she has a good day, that's what we do. We go, thank you, Jesus. We praise you, Lord. We declare her healing. You're not foolish for speaking out your faith. You're foolish for being silent about it. You're foolish when you don't use the gift in you to touch somebody and say, let me pray for you. God is the healer. And in the process of all that, there's always something we are learning. Are you hearing me? Listen to me. In the process of your pain, no matter what it is, you are learning something. When you're a believer, sometimes we can be learning wrong things when we're not a believer. But in the process of our pain, when we start handling it the right way, we start dealing with our issues the right way, when we start touching heaven before we start letting things swirl away in our minds, and we release the word over our lives, we learn something in the moments of pain. We grow in the moments of pain. We grow in the times of struggle. If we will make decisions that are birthed in Jesus. You have takeaways today from this word. I'm not supposed to be preaching. Actually, Prophet Brian is. But I think he's cool because he just then adds to his message. He's like, okay, I got one in the boot. I got one in the church. I got another one for, because I'm actually on half a sabbatical now, for those that don't know. The problem is I never take a full sabbatical. True. But that's coming, right?
Hallelujah.
That's coming.
Yeah.
And I tell you something, God is still the God of glory and grace, and your lives are about to explode. Think of Sozo. Think of the first time you came into the church. Think of the excitement in your life. Don't let the enemy put out your fire. Wow. Don't let the enemy come and put stupid stuff around you that makes you forget about everything God said. Yeah. Our minds have been programmed so wrongly in the earth that it takes time for us to reprogram them so that they are renewed. Are you with me? Hallelujah, someone. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Can you lift your hands and give the Lord a shout?
Hallelujah.
Yes, hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah to our King, hallelujah to our God,
God who thunders, there's healing in his name, praise in his name, healing in his name, Jesus, healing in the name, healing in the name. There's 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 fire in his eyes. This fire in his eyes. This fire in his veins. This fire in his veins. This healing in the name.
So right now, lift your hands up, every person here. You heard how the sound released that came after the word released began to change and shift the atmosphere. and faith has increased in your lives this morning. Where you are standing right now, you got to believe that this morning there's healing in that name. Whatever you're going through, whatever emotional struggle, whatever thing has come, has blocked you, been an obstacle, whatever has come up against you, whatever even in your past that has come and sought to haunt you, I want you to release that right now strategically as a body of Christ, corporately, right where you're standing. Lift your hands up and say, there's healing in that name. I can't hear you. Say it again. There's healing in that name. There's healing in that name.
There's healing in that name.
Come on, sing it with Prophet Brand.
There's healing in the name.
Oh, sing it out, come on.
There's healing in the name.
Yeah.
There's healing in the name.
In the name of Jesus.
There's healing in the name.
In the name of Jesus.
There's healing in the name.
Now receive as the Spirit comes upon you. Receive what God is doing in your life right now. Receive what God is doing in your soul right now. Oh, let the Lord just begin to touch you. Sometimes we don't even know what's going on with us. Sometimes they're just things that overtake our lives, and only after the fact we realize, oh my gosh, I'm so used to dealing with this a certain way that I didn't deal with it at all. But right now, God is showing you some things, releasing you from some things. The Spirit of God is healing you right now. There's healing in that name. There's healing in that name of Jesus. There's healing in that name. There's healing in the name of Jesus. There's healing in that name. Wow.
There's healing in the name.
I see some of you right now, some of you, are praying for your families. Just put your hand up if that's you this morning. You're praying for someone in your family, or they've come into your mind, into your spirit this morning. That's you. Just lift your hand up. I'm not going to. Just let me know. Just put your hand up. Yes, amen, amen. Anybody else? Just right now, lift your. Come on. People in your families that you know need to be saved. People in your families that you know. Right now, there's an anointing on that. Lift your hands up and stand in the gap for them this morning. Let their faces come into your spirit and begin to speak their name under your breath and say, I speak healing over X, whatever their name is, in the name of Jesus. I say, Lord, will you reveal yourself to them right now in the name of Jesus? What decisions they have to make, things that will draw them closer to you. In Jesus' name, I speak healing over my family. Declare the name of that family member. Declare the name of that person right now. Whatever it is, not just physical healing, but emotional healing, spiritual healing. Begin to declare it. Maybe deliverance that they need to see with the eyes of the Spirit. Release it right now over them and say, Lord, give them eyes to see and ears to hear what you are saying. Right now, Lord, we pray that you would send your angels on assignment to those that are being prayed for right now, that you would open the way for them to hear and see, that you would make every opportunity as our prayers go out and ascend to the heavens for them in Jesus' name.
Eyes to see, ears to hear. 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 Oh, eyes to see, ears to hear. Eyes to see, is to see the healing.
Now lift your praises to the Lord just as a corporate body. Just begin to praise the Lord. Begin to pray in the Spirit just for 15 seconds. Speak it out aloud right now. Let the Lord hear your voice. Let this atmosphere be broken with the voice and the sound that you release right now. Shalama kalama robo shalama shendele.
Oh,
tondo, ci mambo sondo, donde anda, ci andanda, ci dande ondono, ci mando donda e andarandea, e mai andea, ci mai andea, ci mai
We've been warring in the spirit. We've been doing some different things this morning. We declared and released the word. Then we began to praise the one who is the word. Then we began to give glory to the Lord. Then we began to worship the Lord. Then the atmosphere changed into a war cry. We 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 changed into a war cry.
We changed into a war cry. We changed into a war cry. We changed into a war cry. We changed into a war cry. We changed into a war cry. We changed into a war cry. We changed into a war cry. We changed into the war cry. Oh, hear the sound of the war cry. 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 Oh, hear my sound of my war cry. 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 Hear the sound.
So the word says in James chapter 2, we don't want evidence. We don't want to have to present the evidence before the faith, right? And then they're speaking about deeds and faith and all the rest, and he says, was not our father Abraham considered righteous for what he did when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see, his faith and his actions were working together, and his faith was made complete by what he did. The reason many people's faith doesn't grow and it stays the same size is because they speak about faith and hear by faith and have an increase of faith, but then they don't carry it out in their actions. There's a fear. But when you carry it out in your actions, the reality of that begins to shift. His actions were working together and his faith was made complete. By what he did, not by what he said, by what he did. And the scripture was fulfilled in saying, Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. You see, Abraham had righteousness. It wasn't the law that he was under. People think so, but it wasn't. So I want to encourage you today. When we speak about warring in the spirit, we're talking about the Ephesians 6, 10 to 12 scripture, right? And I'm hoping all the scriptures I'm speaking, you're going to go and check me. Because it says we don't war against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers that are in the spirit realm that want to annihilate, kill and destroy us, Jesus said. But he said, listen, don't worry about all that stuff because I've come to bring you life and to give you abundant life. So how many again are living in the abundant life? Very few of us. Because we struggle to walk by faith. We understand faith. We hear by faith. But we don't walk out our faith. And God is challenging the church now for us to begin to walk out our faith in a new and living way. As we begin to speak, let us do. So it is with our mouth and our heart, let it be in our actions. So that the world will see. Because when you declare it with your actions, the Bible says your faith is made complete. Oh, you had 500 sermons in one today. But you understand what God is saying to us, something about faith. There's a rising up of the voice. There's a rising up. The war cry that we were releasing was saying, listen, every desolate place that the enemies try to shovel back under our noses, that the enemies try to come in where there's joy, every desolate place, you have to have streams of living water are going to flow in those places. That's the declaration of war that we were declaring this morning. It was an apostolic war cry that began to resonate in the spirit realm. And when we were doing that, I saw the army of the Lord. an army of Gideon being raised up in this house. Because we can't expect people to follow if we don't follow, right? And we're following the word of the Lord, and we're following what God has set aside in each of our lives. And we're going to pursue the action of that, not just talk about it. Because then people will follow. I'm telling you, God's got something to say to all of us. Look at the army of Gideon and the power they had, because they acted as one. They understood the power that the people had in the Old Testament, in the book of Nehemiah, when Ezra began to read the word of the Lord and what it did, and how they were intentionally listening. How they were, the Bible says that there was a, they were listening attentively to the word of God. So Lord, help us to remove the flesh and to understand from the Spirit what you are saying to us. That when we have our quiet time tomorrow, even as we walk out this house, we'll say, Lord, what are you saying to me? What are you telling me? What do you want to teach me from this word on Sunday? Go back and watch it again. It's going to be reposted, even though it didn't come out on the live stream. And I'm so sorry for all you live streamers. It's not coming directly from our local church. It's actually from the service providers. I think with all the flooding we've had here, they're having some problems. But you will be able to see this, because you're seeing it now if you're listening to my voice. We're going to be reposting it. Everyone, listen, there's a sound being released from heaven right now in this place. There's an anointing that's shifted some things. Anybody feel a shift this morning? Anybody feel the shift in the different stages of what God was doing this morning? Oh, hallelujah. Get ready, church. I'm telling you, look at the army of Gideon. Don't look and say, wait for someone to stand up and be counted. You stand up and be counted. Don't wait for someone because you think they're better than you. You stand up and everybody else will. You've got to start standing up. Hallelujah. You got to stand up and walk the walk of faith and move in it, and then it will be complete in you. And so I speak blessing. I say, Lord, just begin to bring over our minds all good things. To touch us, Lord, not just in our hearts, but that our mouths would project what is inside our hearts. And that our actions would follow through, God, so that our faith may be complete. For you are about to raise up an army of Gideon in this house. Oh, Shakarabasha, surely, surely that is so. For the enemy has tried to contend against this house so many times. It is incomprehensible what God is about to do. And I believe that with every fiber of my being, every part of who I am, I don't need to live in some false sense of reality. I live right here on the ground. I know what it's like to serve in the house of the Lord. And all the more as we see the day approaching, let's stand and be counted. Let's grab hold of hands around us and begin to fight like the army of Gideon, strategically in the spirit, unified by the voice that we know is the God of glory and grace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody say, I'm a soldier of the Most High God.
I'm a soldier.
Somebody say, I got power in the name of Jesus. Somebody else say, I got the authority in the name of Jesus. I got the authority to call that mountain. I got the authority to tell that mountain to move. Oh, you got to say it. I got the authority to tell that mountain to move. To begin to speak with my mouth in the name of Jesus, and to know that it reaches the heavens, and that by faith it shall be done. Horava shakara bakara bushundolo basai solamashebake. I've called you out of darkness and into my light. I've called you in a time when there's darkness in the earth. But my light will shine again. My people will rise again. For I'm the great I am, and my word never fails. Hear my voice, hear my word. Oh, my people, know my love is endless for you. The great I am goes before you. Nothing can stop you. As you go, 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 as you go. Speak my name, speak my name, speak my name. Shout it from the rooftops. Oh. Speak my name, speak my name, speak my name. Shout it from the rooftops.
Shout it from the rooftops. Shout it from the rooftops.
Shukalama, shalama, shalama. Shikalama, ma, 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 ma. Someone's got a prophetic word here. Someone's got a prophetic word here. You've got to release it before I close the service. Shulama, kalama, shulama, shalama, shulo. Shalama, shulama, shulama. You've got the word.
I just keep getting the image of an arrow. It's one of the most fierce weapons that we have. But for an arrow to be fired, it's got to be pulled back. It's intention. But there's an aim that needs to be taken place before that arrow is fired. So if you feel that you are being pulled back, get ready for that release that is coming. Because God is aiming you as a deadly weapon in God's army. So be ready to hit that target. Don't dread the pulling back. Don't resist the pulling back. But be ready and be focused for what God is about to do and release through you and in you. For you will be on target. You will be the fiery arrow.
Thank you. Anyone else have a word? You've got a word on that word. There's a word on the word. There's a word on the word. There's a word on the word. Shakaba sendelebe. There's a word on the word. Sholoma kalama mama mama shanda. Sholoma kalama mama mama mama. Do you have a word, Ilonka?
You just speak what the Lord put in your heart. I don't know where the scripture is. There's a scripture in the Word where it talks about how your tongue needs to be pulled back. How you pull your... Is it? Your tongue being pulled back like a bow and releasing. And that I just found that's totally on. I don't know what it means, but I just know that it goes with that.
So the Lord says, harness what I've put inside of you. Harness what I've put inside of you. Let it be released in the right time, in the right season, but harness what I've put inside of you. Let it not run wild, but be harnessed inside of you so that it can be released in the right order, in the right time, and in the right place.
How many received the word this morning? Come on, give the Lord a shout. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, we've been praying a long time for musicians to come. Can you see why? Do you see the sounds as they shift and change? They create different atmospheres for different wars and for different things. We've got to pray. Hallelujah. We've been praying for some time for duplications of our musicians so that we can have teams that go on mission, that we can have different teams to take over, different teams to be grown and replicated. Keyboard players, bass players, drummers. We need a drummer. Come on, someone in the house. You got to pray. You got to pray for musicians. You got to pray for God to begin to raise up an army. Amen. And if there's any one of you here, you need to tell us if you know that God has brought you here, because that is what you're called to do. I speak right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. Let the angel armies be released into the city of Durban so that the city and the region and the nation shall be touched in the LGBTI and affirming communities. And all that would hear the name of the Lord will be saved. And all that would hear the name of the Lord will be delivered and will be testimonies, walking testimonies of your glory in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody shout it out.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, oh. Hallelujah. Woo. Who's doing the offering word? Hallelujah. Please be seated. You all been standing all this time? Hallelujah.
The Lord's been laying a number of things on my heart recently, and I had about four or five scriptures. And one of the scriptures that I discarded when I was preparing the offering word was, and the scripture was fulfilled that says Abraham believed God and it was credited to him as righteousness. So the Lord is going to get that out. So obviously, and he was called God's friend. And the reason why that came to me Also because I was thinking about the law, how I am obligated, because the Bible says I have to give my tithe. So I have to give my tithe. And it started weighing down on me very heavily. Just a little bit of background. I came from an Anglican upbringing where you sit, kneel, stand, repeat. Sit, kneel, stand, repeat. And you read from the liturgy, and here's your offering time. And it was very much a, if you don't do it, you're a bad Anglican. All right. And that unfortunately was playing on my mind a lot. And then I got Galatians 3 verse 11. Clearly no one who relies on the law is justified before God, because the righteous will live by faith. And I thought, so it's not my action, it's not my compliance to the law that makes me righteous. It's not my compliance before the Lord that makes me a friend of God. So is that me creaking? because in Psalm 51, David says, "You do not delight in sacrifice, or I would bring it. You do not take pleasure in burnt offerings. My sacrifice, the money which I'm sacrificing to give to the Lord, but my sacrifice, O God, is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart. God, you will not despise." And I realize that I don't give my offering or my gift, my tithe. I don't give my love to the Lord out of a sense of duty, but from a heart of truth, from a broken heart, from a heart that responds because I know who God is and I know who I am. I'm not worthy of what God has done, but I am found righteous through Christ and through my faith. And all I want to do is demonstrate my love and my faith in God by giving to God what belongs to God first. So I just want to encourage you, if you're feeling like you have to do this or you have to do that, don't. Don't do anything out of because you have to. But do it because your heart is overflowing with love for God, especially when it comes to the fact that this time of the month and we're heading towards the festive season and we're counting our pennies. Know that God is faithful. As Apostle Deb quoted Matthew chapter 5, where Jesus was saying, even the birds in the air are looked after. Won't your heavenly parent look after you? So don't worry about that. But give what the Lord has laid on your heart and give out of love. So the baskets are here. I do encourage you now. Bring your offering of love as an act of worship to your God.
Ooh, everything I am to you.
We just praise you that we can come into your house and give you these small gifts of our love. Thank you, Lord, for your abundance. Thank you, Lord, for all that you poured out. Thank you, Lord, that we can return to you all that is yours. Thank you, Lord, that your word says that we will be blessed when we give to the house. And I pray your blessing upon these and your blessing upon every person who gave to your home, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Your giving is your act of worship. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Please join us for some eats, coffee, fellowship, tea, whatever it is you prefer. We'd love to hang with you for a while. And don't forget, life groups on Thursday. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Amen.
Amen.